Alright, take a breath. If you're outside, take a breath. If not, open the window. Let some fresh air in. Let some light in. The haiku for this week. I often speak of love. A little different today. These are fearsome times. Do not engage the darkness. Live and speak your truth. That's what we got to do now, man. You're faced with the darkness. The truth will dissolve the darkness. Got to be patient, but it does it. The I Ching, the ancient oracle, comes to us 5,000 years of history, coming to life for us here at the last month of 2016. This is the I Ching reading for the week of December 5th, 2016. Number 46, Shang, ascending. Above is Kun, which is the yin element, and below is the root foundation. Like the wind goes with small and steady efforts. Wisdom, this is the time of ascension. It is now vital to be present. Be mindful of where you stand and ask for what you need. If you don't ask, you ain't gonna get it. This is the season of harvesting, your personal harvest. In this case, consists of the ripe fruits of small and steady efforts. Even paying attention to details, remaining steadfast to the principles, and even keeping in mind that benefit will come from working for the greater good. It has seemed as if the fruits of your efforts have been elusive. You're going to benefit now by moving away from having any expectations. In the present confluence of aligning planets and selfless acts, your expectations are about to be humbled by the good fortune that is coming your way. Good news. Good news. Chariots are coming. The energy and ideas that have been elusive are now in reach. Actually, if you pay attention, they're in your hands. You simply need to be steady. Steady your heart. And have recognition of your gifts and clearly recognize what is yours. All possibilities are available to you now. The benefit is to not become arrogant or complacent. Be active and seize your dreams. Carpe diem. This is a short window that's open now to take action in the benefits that are there. In summoning your self-worth, this will be your benefit now. If you do not believe that you're worthy of your dream, it will pass you by and leave you grasping at the wind. Do this. Repeat this inner mantra. I am good enough and I deserve, and you just fill in the blank. I deserve, fill in the blank. You deserve love, success, abundance, health, whatever is your desire, fill it in. It would sound like this. I am good enough and I deserve love, right? Whatever your desire is, as you make your move toward the benefits for what you've desired and dreamed, be positive and know that you do deserve it for the work that you've done and just for being who you are. You know, we forget who we are. We come into this life so pure and then we forget. Lots of stuff happens. School, parents, siblings, government. And we build up all these walls, all these energies, all these skins. As you peel away the skin, you find that you are beautiful and you deserve. In the recent past, you felt like your waiting period has been interminable, right? That was your analytical mind interfering with the universal laws of right timing because everything is on time. Patience and quiet nurturing is what is needed now, whether in relationship to your inner self or in projects, external relationships, and your connection with your home planet. You remember her, our Earth. Without service to the ecology and wellness of our Earth and her sentient beings, of which you are one, your accomplishments will be empty and without meaning. There's no doubt about it, and be without doubt that what you've desired, what you've desired is coming your way. Don't ask when, just be awake and prepared to receive. This means be still and listen. You will be shown and you will be told. Just listen. You might be told by the sound the wind makes, really, or the bird song. Man, I remember it's a story after a dear, dear friend passed away. And I was walking down the street, and I was thinking about it. And I passed a man who appeared to be homeless sitting on a bus bench and had a tattered coat. And as I walked by, he said, "Hey, you know, Justine's okay." And that was her name. And gave me chills and shivers. So, just listen. You will be told. Trust and faith combined is a powerful recipe that will propel you forward in your quest for what is right and in harmony with the natural way of being. Quiet your heart and mind. Allow the natural way to unfold. Be steady and don't miss a step. Progress and prosperity are assured. All things that you've worked and wished for are moving forward. Don't doubt it. They're moving toward yours and for the greater good. Trust that your intuition is at an extremely high level. And trust and make well-considered moves, no matter what you've been striving for. Bring all together and be the giver of love and the giver of life in your tribe, in your family, in your relationships, at work, or maybe just walking down the street. Be love. Be love. Know well that while you harvest the bounty that is available to you now, the benefit will be to return this energy in equal measure to the living organism of your community, and to Gaia, to which you are deeply rooted. This is your family, which has silently and elegantly supported and nurturing you so that you could get to this point of beneficial harvest. Keep feeding the whole, the oneness of which we are each a part. Fail this, and you fail yourself. Yeah, there'll be nobody to blame, man. You know, the narcissist who looks around and says they're right and everybody else is wrong. Doesn't work that way. Mr. Trump, doesn't work that way. Know well and have confidence in the work you've done. Know that you've correctly nurtured yourself, nurtured your relationships, nurtured your tribe, nurtured your projects to this point. And pay no attention to that yapping voice, the voice of the negative ego, adhering to this voice will be a useless exercise that will leave you weak and pitiful. Have faith that your growth is assured. If you allow everything to unfold without the judgment or interference of the critical, analytical mind, you're going to be all right. Refrain from picking things apart. Just let the mind relax. Let it be free in this vast space of consciousness, as you open your consciousness to a deeper and deeper place. Now, drawing this hexagram is telling us that personal magic could not be at a higher and more beneficial point. Ideas will be well received. Externally, you'll advance in relationships, you'll advance in your career, and your words will be heard. So if you know your words are going to be heard, speak up. Really, tell the truth. The truth will tear apart all the stuff that is being heaped upon the world at this moment, right? I've been paying attention. They say 2016 was a bad year. I don't know. I think it was a year that really woke us up and woke us up to say, man, you cannot get it, be asleep at the wheel, because if you are, it ain't going to be pretty. So we got to be awake and make this next year. 2017 and 2018 are going to be some of the best years that society has had. We're well on our way to the new golden age, and I believe it, and I see it, and I feel it. I see it when I lecture, when I meet people around the world, and I see the light in everybody, this light that is growing, and it's a hungry light. We got to feed the hungry light, right? What do we feed it with? Compassion? Truth? Love? Yeah. Stay steady now and remain humble. Because as the bounty comes, it's going to seem pretty amazing. It is about you, but it's also about the confluence of energies that we spoke about. Honor your practice. Take part in activities that keep you centered, grounded, and joyous. By adhering to the higher laws, those of compassion, kindness, and integrity, what you will gain will remain. And any doubts about yourself will wash away like the dust after a longed-for spring rain. This week, listen to the wind as it speaks to you. Hear the waters as they flow and nurture and teach you. Celebrate fire as it burns away the dross. Taste of the earth as she nurtures all sentient beings and wears. And you will wear the air on your skin like a royal robe of ritual and celebration. As you partake in the fruits and vegetables of the earth, taste her in your mouth. Taste her as you would taste the body of your lover and celebrate in knowing that all is good and all is right and we are one. It really is true. We're connected to the animals and to the fruits and to the vegetables. Ah. Eat plants. Eat plants. Let the plants nurture you and feed you. The bounty of our earth is magnificent. Return to the health and knowing that you are love. Every once in a while we get a reaction, you know, our skin will go nuts, or you know, we'll break out, or we'll get aches, or we'll get cramps, or you know, it'll happen, we'll get headaches, whatever, it happens. Well, stop and try not to get angry and deconstruct what was happening before this happened. What was it? What was out of balance? You know, was it your diet, your attitude, your feeling? Were you under attack? Were you under stress? Whatever it was, you know, it happens. So open up. Do ritual. Do celebration. Get ready. Holidays are coming, man. Really celebrate and say goodbye to this year. But recognize that the year has been a year of teaching, year of learning. Year of what we truly want, what we truly deserve. Don't be afraid. Say what you mean and mean what you say. Goddesses, walk as a goddess. Warriors, walk as a warrior. Come together. The warrior goddess, the warrior hero, the men, the women, these beautiful sentient beings that are on the planet. Come together now. Do the work. Find inspiration. You know, if the work you're doing seems tainted, see what's doing it. If the relationship seems toxic, see what the poison is. All things are being exposed now. So we must pay attention. We must act. These are fearsome times. Do not engage the darkness. Live and speak your truth. Hey, have a beautiful, beautiful week. Open the doorways. This is a time of ascension. A time of abundance. A time of love. If you can right now, stand up and jump up and down a few times. I'm serious. See how it feels. Yeah. You're awake. Be awake. Namaste, my brothers. Namaste, my sisters. In Lakesh Alakim. I am the other you. And I like it that way. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Namaste. Namaste. Light some candles tonight. Dance with the wind. Take off your clothes. Feel the wind on you. Dance. Be loved. Teach peace. Namaste.